this shortly. So what equipment do we need? We'll set up, we'll take across the iSIM and the catheter, and we need the catheter bag. We've got the paperwork from last week on. Let me just print off some feedback forms, and then we're ready to go. Great, we're here for Sim Training today. Have you got an available bed for us?
Yeah, I think so. I've got bed E6000, which is a bit white.
Okay,
yeah,
we'll go and set them over there.
I'll take the bed.
Thanks very much. Training here before,
yes.
And you use the iSIM before, now she
uses
it?
Yes.
So we use the iSIM as the monitor. You've got your normal monitor here, so you can attach those as you need them. And then the only, if there's something that you need, so they're not, if you want the SATs, you just say, I'm adding the SATs very long now, we'll bring the SATs up. And if we start with you, and then Sally and Mohammed, if you hang around nearby, and then there's any need to be involved, then we'll call that up. This is Cyril White. So he's a patient who's had a stroke and has come across from the high acute stroke unit at the Royal London. And this is, he's just arrived, the ambulance crew have gone, and they've left you with the transfer letter.
Hello, Mr. White. My name's Nadine, I'm the nurse. I'm going to be looking after you, okay? Do you have any pain anywhere?
Can you shake his head?
I'm just going to call the doctor, okay? And I'll be back. Okay, this is a 84-year-old who's coming from the London with acute stroke. We've got a CBA. Just got this information
based on Sally, have you seen the patient?
No.
Okay, so can we check his blood glucose first of all? Is what, Mr. White, isn't it?
Yes.
Mr. White? Mr. White?
His eyes are opening, but he's not really communicating. Okay. Little green bag. Got to find just a kind of losing my mind.
He wants to put the eye through the star, say, mention to him that this patient is hemodynamically unstable. We try to build the system. We have done the blood fractures, the venous blood gas, which shows that this is -6.
What do you think went well as a team?
Everybody knew what they were doing. Mohammed delegated really well.
Yep.
And Sally was really like, you know, should I do this? And I think she wanted to really take the blood, put the cannula in, but I probably couldn't do it.
And actually they've been sometimes, as well as I'm asking them to do some jobs, sometimes they've been guiding me through because there's long process involving these annotations, and sometimes you miss bits and pieces. So Sally has highlighted to me this patient is feverish, and she mentioned to me the hydrocortisone, which was very helpful. Sometimes you just forget these things as you go.